Building last night for a private viewing for Capitol Police officers. President Biden was also there to pay his respects. Sicknick's cremated remains will lie in honor at the Capitol Rotunda until burial at Arlington National Cemetery, scheduled for later today. This Friday, funeral services will take place for longtime Miami Valley State Trooper Brad Huffman. Huffman died of COVID-19 late last month. The Ohio State Highway Patrol said the viewing will begin at 10 a.m. with a funeral service to follow at noon. Then there will be a police procession at around 1:15 leading to Woodland Cemetery in Xenia. Huffman spent most of his 23 years of service with the State Patrol in Xenia. Good morning to you. Happy Wednesday. 5:17. It's just 19 degrees and it feels even colder than that. Let's get the update on this cold forecast. Oh, and it's going to get worse. By the way, here's Storm Center 7 meteorologist Jesse Mag.
Yeah, people are not going to like me here over the next week or so, maybe even beyond that because of the forecast we have in store for you. Now, right now, it is fairly quiet. It's definitely cold, but I think your driving conditions are going to be A-OK here today because all the sunshine that we had yesterday worked to melt and even dry off the road. So that is the good news I have for you. But it is 19 degrees with a wind coming out of the northwest at this point, 5 to 10 miles per hour. So when you add it together, it feels like we're down into the single digits across the Miami Valley. And believe it or not, it gets much, much colder than that. I'll talk about that in a second. Right now on satellite, you see some clouds coming off of Lake Erie. That's not affecting us. Clouds coming off of Lake Michigan, also not affecting us because our air is coming straight from Michigan, the land itself, and that's very dry air. So we're going to see more sunshine out there today, especially as high pressure moves in overhead. Now, our temperatures, not necessarily warm. We only pick up to about 30 degrees or so, but with the winds settling down a bit compared to yesterday, I think today's probably the best that we're going to see over about the next 10 days or more. Now, tomorrow, the clouds move back in, and temperatures are going to warm up as well. You see that chance for a wintry mix moving in towards the end of the afternoon? That's going to be very brief. In fact, I think we see with this system that moves in, a lot more rain than any snowflakes. You see those warmer temperatures moving in. Now on the tail end, you get colder air moving in. That could switch us very briefly to a wintry mix or some snowflakes. But by and large, this system through the overnight hours Thursday into Friday morning is really going to lean towards rain. We have another system that's going to be moving in after that, kind of a squeeze of moisture as colder air is coming in. This is Saturday night into the early morning hours on Sunday. This one is going to be all snow because our temperatures by this point in time are going to be really cold already. So when this moves in, we get some of that moisture squeezed out as snow overhead, and it's going to be light stuff. But we could possibly see some snow accumulation with that, so keep an eye on Sunday morning. Take a look at our temperature trend over the next 5 days. You get that deceiving bump to about 40 degrees tomorrow, but then we take a nosedive here. Check out Sunday. That's the high temperature at 16 degrees. Let me take you 6 to 10 days farther than that. Cold. That's what it's going to be. And it looks like, in fact, I've looked for most of the month of February just to kind of get a gauge on the pattern. Kind of looks like that. So it's going to be cold here for February. We're going to see conditions really from the Arctic dip down into the Midwest and here into the Great Lakes, and that will certainly affect us, especially as we head into Sunday, and I'm thinking just about all of next week is going to be bitter cold. So here's a look at Wednesday. Sunny skies, take advantage of it because we have some rain moving in Thursday night and into Friday. Now that next system, snow's moving in overnight Saturday and into Sunday morning. At that point, the cold air arrives. 16 for the high temperature on Sunday, and all of next week will likely be at the warmest in the 20s, but likely several days in the teens, with wind chills possibly dropping 10 to 20 degrees below zero. We're bringing you weather and traffic every 10 minutes. Let's head over to Sergeant Mark and check on the roads. Good morning, Sarge.
Justin, I'm glad we're not dealing with any of that stuff yet. I feel like putting my coat on right now, actually, after hearing Jesse's report. But actually, if you're headed out to the freeway, we're in good shape right now. Things look good on 75 and the rest of the freeway. Speaking of the freeway, here is Interstate 70. This camera is at Airport Access Road. Lanes are clear here. Travel times are good. Really haven't come across any accidents or other issues so far. I'm Sergeant Mark Bowen, WHIO Team Traffic.
Sergeant, thank you. 5:21 now, it's 19 degrees. UPS has found a unique way to celebrate Black History Month. The creative boxes getting delivered that honor African Americans. Tesla is recalling thousands of vehicles. The problem with the center screen that's posing a safety issue.